Hello and welcome everyone. I got this question from a user. Now, he has this table and what he wants to do is if this field, this lookup field is set to that value, he wants to hide this child tab, the tab link and the tab contents as well. So basically this is achievable by using some JavaScript code. First, we need to identify the value selected in that lookup field, and if it meets a certain value, then we want to hide that child tab. So, I don't have the project itself, so I will not be using this specific example, but I'll use a similar example from our Northwind demo. So, in the orders table, we have an employee lookup field, and we want to set it similarly. If the employee is set to a specific value, then we want to hide the order items child tab and its contents. So to do this, let's open the inspector window by pressing F12. And now the employee field is named employee ID. So I type here $j hash employee ID, which is the name of the field, dot val. So this displays 8. So 8 is the ID of the currently selected employee. So what we want to do is retrieve the value of the selected employees through this instruction, $j employee ID dot val, or $j hash field name dot val. And if the value is set to a specific value, let's say 8, if it meets that condition, we'll hide the order items child tab. So to hide the order items child tab, let's inspect this part to be able to select it. So the tab is displayed in the HTML code like this. We have an anchor with an ID of tab underscore order details dash order ID. So this is basically tab underscore, then the child table name, then the lookup field name. So we can copy the ID of the tab. And now note that to hide that part, we need to go to its parent li item and hide that part. So if we go to the console here and type this selector $j hash and the ID we just copied, now we want to reach its parent, which is li, and add class hidden. So as you can see, this basically hides the tab. It didn't hide the content yet. We'll reach that part later on, but it did hide the tab. So this is the code we need to do to hide the tab. Now if we want to redisplay it later, we can replace add class with remove class to do so. What we did is replacing add class hidden with remove class hidden. So we removed the hidden class and it's displayed again. Now, this is the part of hiding the tab itself. What about the content of the tab? So to hide the content of the tab, let's go back to the inspector, inspect this element. And the content is placed inside a div that has a class tab content. If you open that div, we'll see another div that has this ID, and this is the div that we need to hide. Now we could, if we are seeing multiple tabs here, we'll see several divs under the tab content. So we need to select the appropriate div that we want to hide. Okay. In our case, there is only one content div, so we have just selected that one. So what we need to do to hide it is use similar logic. $j hash and the ID of the tab content we want to hide, and we'll add class hidden. And as you can see, it's now hidden. So if we combine both commands, that command we just typed now and the other command for typing, for hiding that tab title, now the entire tab is hidden now. So our logic goes like this. First of all, we retrieve the value of our lookup field through this command. If the value meets a specific condition, let's say if $jEmployeeID.val equal 8, in that case, we'll hide a specific child tab. And that tab is tab order details order ID dot parents li dot add class hidden. This will hide the title of the tab, and to hide the content of the tab, we'll also use this command panel order details order ID dot add class hidden. So this is in case the employee ID value meets this specific condition. If it doesn't meet it, we'll reverse our hiding by using remove class instead of add class hidden. I hope this makes it clear. And of course, the question is where to add this code. We should add it in the table name -dv.js file inside the hooks folder. So in this case, our table is named orders. So we should add our code into orders-dv.js inside the hooks folder. I hope this makes it clear, and thank you for watching.